Hey guys, today I'm showing you how to bleach your knots on a lace wig so that your wig can look as natural as possible. Here I'm just showing you the difference between bleached and unbleached knots and what you should look for. The wig I am using today is coming from AliExpress Wonder Girl. I am using the Clairol BW2 Powder and 30 Developer. As you can see from this close-up, the knots are not bleached at all, period. So we're just going to jump right into it and show you how to do so. I'm also showing you the length. This is a 150 density 20-inch wig. Here I am showing you the different combs that they have inside. It also has an adjustable strap. Now me personally, I cut the combs out because I do not use them at all. So now we're going to go ahead and turn our wig inside out so we can start the bleach process. Here I am removing the excess hair out of the way, and I am going to start pinning down my wig to my head. Also off camera, I went ahead and mixed together my bleach powder and my developer. If you can, make sure you do have gloves so that you can protect your hands, because getting that bleach on your hand will start to burn. We're going to go ahead and start bleaching the wig. I start off at the front of the hair because that's where the thinner it is. And then I work my way up. And I will fast forward this video so we won't have to waste so much time. When bleaching the wig, just make sure that you do not press extremely hard on your cap. If you do, your bleach will seep through and start bleaching the hair and the knots, and you don't want over bleached hair, because then that's a whole nother different process you got to worry about. Now we place the aluminum foil on just to make sure everything is processed correctly. You will leave this foil on for about 15 to 20 minutes just to make sure everything is processed. Here we went ahead and started to wash this bleach out. Here I'm just showing you that I am using my purple shampoo to take away that brassiness on your wig. You will hear a lot of people talk about purple shampoo. Some put purple dye into their bleach mix. Whatever your preference, just make sure you use some type of purple shampoo or dye just to make sure all of that brassiness come out of your wig. I find it very important to wash and condition your wig. With bleaching especially, or dyeing, you want to make sure that all of those chemicals are out of your wig. Otherwise, your wig will shed like crazy and or it will itch your scalp to the max. Conditioning your wig is really good because it gives your hair back that bouncy, that straightness, that shine that it needs, just as much as your real hair. That's what people seem to forget, that wigs or weave is just like having your real hair in your head, your real natural hair. It sheds just like your hair and everything above. So here I'm just showing you the outcome of this wig. As you can see, when I first got it, it was very just not good looking. Here it looks like a natural scalp. Also, I did not put on a cap up under this wig, so it's just my natural scalp. I really love the outcome of this wig. I didn't have to worry about putting concealer on there or any other products besides just laying the hair down itself and laying my baby hair down, which right now it is giving me a tough time, as you can see. However, we're gonna get this together, trust me. Here I have my Jane Carter Wrap and Roll Setting Mousse so that I can make sure my hair is slicked down for the gods. One thing I like about this setting spray is the fact that it doesn't make your hair extremely hard like most mousse. Here I take my hot comb and just make sure everything is straight, laid down, and in place so I won't have any flyaways that would get in the way. This is my wig all done up and finished. I did not tweeze any of the knots at all. I just really wanted to go ahead and finish this video for you guys. But just know that you can't always be perfect when it comes to these wigs, but depending on how the wig was made and how it's going to process the bleach.